Hi, myself Ohe M. Keshavlu, Associate Professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronic Engineering at Annamacharya Institute of Technology and Sciences, Rajampet. As a part of International FDP on Environment and Sustainability, I am giving a brief description about energy management, its standards, calculation of footprint and sustainability. In the week 1, I have explained about significance of energy management, steps involved in measurement of energy management, energy saving tips. In the similar manner, in the week 2, a brief description was given about various standards of energy management, significance of Energy Star, ISWR, ISI, ISO 5001 energy management. The video outcomes are, it defines energy management, explains steps involved in management of energy management, illustrates various energy saving tips, analyzes standards of energy management, summarize ISO 5001 energy management, calculates footprint and sustainability. The graph represents the consumption of household utilities. 36% of energy was consumed by air conditioners, 21% water heater, 18% refrigerated TV and computer, 11% lighting, 4% kitchen appliances, 4% 3% by washing machine, 2% by fan, and remaining 1% by other utilities. In order to minimize the household energy consumption, certain standards have to be followed. Those standards are ISI, Indian Standards Institution. The symbol is represented as given in the symbol. ISI mark is a standard compliance mark for industrial products in India since 1955. The mark certifies that a product conforms to an Indian standard developed by the Bureau of Indian Standards, BIS, the Indian National Standards Body of India. Next standard is International Organization for Standardization, represented by ISO. ISO is a global organization that works to provide standardization across an array of products and companies. Its main goal is to facilitate trade, but its focus is on process improvement, safety and quality in several areas. Next standard is Indian Seasonal Energy Efficiency Ratio. It is represented by ISWR. This star rating is provided for customer awareness by BEE, Bureau of Energy Efficiency. This star rating is utilized while purchasing the air conditioner for saving the energy. Similarly, ISO 5001, it is related to energy management. The purpose is use data to better understand and make decisions about energy use, measures the results, review how well the policy works, and continually improve energy management. Now I would like to explain about carbon emission. Carbon emission is the release of carbon into the atmosphere. There are both natural and human resources of carbon dioxide emission. Natural resources include decomposition, ocean release, and respiration. Human sources come from activities like cement production, deforestation, as well as the burning of fossil fuels like coal, oil, natural gas. Green gas emissions are often measured in carbon dioxide equivalent. Carbon footprint. Carbon footprint is historically defined as the total greenhouse gas emission caused by an individual, organization or product expressed as carbon dioxide equivalent. Greenhouse gases, including the carbon containing gases, carbon dioxide and methane, can be emitted through the burning of fossil fuels, land clearance and production of consumption of food, manufactured food, materials, wood, roads, buildings, transport and other services. All this constitutes the carbon emissions. The figure represents the various forms: transportation, offsets, electricity, gas. These are the various forms of production of carbon emission. I have taken an example of housing. To calculate housing footprint, it's necessary to work out our personal share of home energy use, water use and waste. This means collecting figures for our home's annual energy, water and waste use and dividing it by the number of people in our home to get our individual share. After this information, then by multiplying personal by an emission factor to calculate our home footprint. Carbon emission calculation is shown in the this form. Electricity use a kilowatt per hour in emission factor kg CO2 emission per kilowatt hour, that equals to emission kg kilowatt emissions per year. Similarly, for natural gas unit is terms. Similarly, for fuel, it is measured in terms of liter. LPG, it is measured in terms of liter. Waste, it is measured in terms of kgs. Water, it is measured in terms of liter. Each of the usages are person per year. For example, if our home utilization 3000 kilowatt hour of electricity a year, and if it is shared with two other people, then individual share of electricity usage will be 1000 kilowatt hour. For the purpose of calculation of footprint, I have taken the region that I am residing, that is Andhra Pradesh. I have considered three members family just are supposed to use 2 LP cylinder per month, and they are going to travel an average distance by bus 100 kilometers and by 4 wheeler 25 kilometers, and the electricity consumption per month is 250 kilometers. Based on the given data, the footprint is given in the form of bar graph represented in this way. So electricity is going to produce a carbon emission of 0.76, LPG 0.325, bus 1.917, 4 wheeler 0.29, and the net carbon footprint is 3.92 tons. The world's average is 4 tons, and the Indian average is 1.3 tons of CO2 equivalent. This have taken from the reference of ICCA.com Go Green Carbon World Day. Next, I would like to explain about the sustainability computation. As I belong to electrical engineering, I have taken example of lighting. Compact fluorescent light bulbs, also known as CFLs, offer an efficient lighting solution for many applications in the residential and commercial sectors. They can make an important contribution to stabilizing and even reducing the global energy demand for lighting. The greatest potential of this technology is that it offers an alternative to inefficient lamps such as incandescent bulbs, which are currently the main lamp in usage in many countries. Using CFL instead of incandescent bulb can mean energy savings of 80% or more. And I would like to prove this one with the help of simple example. CFLs use 1/3 to 1/5 the electrical power of incandescent lighting and can last 8 to 15 times longer. An average CFL bulb which provides 800 lumens will use only 13 to 15 watts compared to a similar incandescent bulb which uses 60 watts. So I have taken the lighting technology of 800 lumens with the incandescent bulb of 60 watts, and CFL of same lumens is produced by 14 watts. If you are going to consume daily at 8 hours, kilowatt hour is 0.48 for incandescent, 0.11 for CFL. So annual kilowatt hour consumed is 175.2, whereas with CFL 40.15. And the CO2 produced by incandescent is 152.42, CFL is 34.93. So it's better choice of to replace incandescent bulbs with the CFL in order to reduce the CO2 emissions. So think green. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.